Street Pride Riders and the Leader Riders and Iron Horse Riders. Give them a big round of applause. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I know it's really hot today. It's not raining, but it is hot. So I want you to make sure you get plenty of water. We have water over there. And let's use the buddy system. Take care of one another. If we see somebody having a hard time, just make sure we get them in the shade. And let's just take care of everybody today, because I know it's hot. We're going to keep the program to an hour, but I just want to make sure that everybody's taken care of. So I'll be reminding you, we do have water over there, so make sure you get some water and drink accordingly. One more time for the Patriot Guard Riders, Legion Riders, and our Iron Horse Riders that went through. Okay, as we get set, I just want to remind you, at exactly 1,400 hours, that's 2 o'clock for you civilians, time over target, the Hooligans flight team will be flying 4 T-34 Mentors, 1950-era military training aircraft, and they'll make 3 passes. And today, in honor of all of our veterans here at Fort Custer and around the world that's paid the ultimate sacrifice, the last pass will be the missing man formation. So don't miss it. Again, they'll be doing 3 passes, so get your cameras ready at precisely 1,400 hours. And I've talked to the lead pilot, Tom, and he tells me to exactly 1,400 hours. So if he doesn't get here 1,400 hours, we're gonna make sure that he holds to that. On their second pass, they may not be able to hear us, so they'll be low level. We're all going to wave to them. I'll remind you again, but we're all going to wave to them. You got that? So they can see we appreciate it. All right, so stand by. Make sure you have water. Get in the shade if you need be. Let us know if you're having any problems and stay safe out there. Here they come. Whoa, look at this. The lead pilot is Tom Hibiski from Battle Creek. Left wing is Chuck Stauffer, Battle Creek. Right wing, John Workman from Muskegon, and Bill Kunkel of the slot from Grand Haven. Now they're going to do another pass, so get those cameras ready. It is their privilege and duty to be with us today to recognize and honor those who have given the ultimate sacrifice in defense of our freedom. They ask us to remember that freedom is never free. Get ready. Wave this time. Wave now. Let them know you appreciate it. Everybody wave.
They're behind us.
Well, they probably didn't see me waving then, did they? Okay, now this last pass is going to be in honor of all of us, the missing man formation. Thank you. Hammer's ready. Here we go. Up. One more time for the Hooligan Flight Team. A little later in the program, a couple of their pilots will be back and will be a chance to show us our appreciation for them. Let's give one big thanks again to the Patriot Guard Legion Riders and the Horse Riders. They're back now, so let's give them a big applause for riding through. And the musical prelude by our own Stereo City Concert Band. Now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand if you're able for the presentation of colors and remain standing for the invocation, the Pledge of Allegiance, and our national anthem. Pastor Todd Tervest will deliver the invocation. Brigadier General Robert Secret, U.S. Army retired, will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the playing of our national anthem by the Stereo City Concert Band. The One Attack Wing, the Legion Riders Flag Line, and the Kalamazoo Pipe Band will post our colors. Color Guard, post the colors.
Bow your heads for the invocation. Creator God, in the spirit of community, we pause to reflect upon our blessings as a nation and the high cost of those blessings for many. May we remember your great love for us, and that there is no greater demonstration of that love than to lay one's life down for another. We thank you for the freedom we enjoy in this country, for opportunities to flourish, and for the protection we enjoy. We thank you for those who've served and are serving in the armed services of our country, risking their lives for our liberty. We thank you for those who have given their lives in service to our country, sacrificing in such a costly way for the sake of others. Thank you for this time set apart, not just for celebration, but also for solemn remembrance as we consider the sacrifices made by so many in our military. Grant that our reflections today pay homage to all of those who have served and those who are serving. To honor their legacy, we commit ourselves to be more vigilant in our love for others, for our nation, the cause of freedom, justice, and peace throughout the world. Amen.
Introduced during the wreath laying ceremony. If you represent a military veteran organization, please stand or raise your hand so we can acknowledge you and all the great work you do on behalf of our veterans and their families. Please stand. Plenty of them out there. Also in attendance, we have a number of political and civic community leaders. To ensure I don't miss anyone, I would like for you to stand if you're a political or community leader so we can acknowledge you for your support to our military family. And of course, all of our military veterans and their families, let's give them a big warm applause. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker. Colonel Curtis J. Bomer is commander of the Michigan Wing Civil Air Patrol, which is one of six wings within the Great Lakes region. It has over 1,400 members and performs Civil Air Patrol's missions for America, aerospace education, cadet programs, and emergency services. Michigan Wing partners with many outside organizations, such as the Michigan National and Air National Guards, the U.S. Border Patrol, Michigan State Police, many schools, and other youth organizations. Colonel Bomer grew up in Civil Air Patrol family and is a 1974 recipient of the General Billy Mitchell Award. In 1984, he received the Gil Rob Wilson Award. As a CAP senior member, Colonel Bomer has held a number of command positions. He was the youngest group commander in Michigan Wing history at 27 years old. He has served as squadron commander for over 15 years and a five-time encampment commander and director of two National Cadet Special Activities Advanced Computer Technology. In addition, he has served as the director of the cadet programs for the Michigan Wing for three tours, twice as a wing chief of staff and twice as the wing vice commander. He was certified observer and ground team member. Colonel Bomer also sits on the board of advisors for TKE of Oakland University and Lake Superior State University and is a trained state-approved court mediator. Curtis is married to his wife Shelley of 33 years, and together they have one son, Lance. Curtis and Shelley reside in Harbor Beach, Michigan. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to a great friend of mine, Colonel Curtis Bomer.
Thank you, Colonel Walker. Ladies and gentlemen, veterans, I am humbled and honored to be here today. Today, on this day of remembrance and honoring, we gather here to recognize the men and women in our armed forces, our heroes who have paid the ultimate sacrifice, both in war and in peace. To protect this great country and the American way of life, we are here to honor the memory of our fallen, who have proudly served this great nation and their families, whose sacrifice I cannot even imagine. For they are the fabric from which our flag is woven, and our nation relies on them for the protection of our dream. The dream that both inspires people around the world and terrifies those that seek to control and abuse and deny freedom to people they lead. Over the course of my life in Civil Air Patrol, I've often been asked by those who don't understand the military very well why we send our young people and our family members to war. Why do we sacrifice so much of our nation's treasure for people and nations around the world? At first, I struggled for an answer. I was reading one day and came upon a piece by Lillian Leader. Here's the question that Lillian asked, and I ask you the same question today. Have you ever looked, really looked at a soldier's face? Sometimes it's young, barely an adult, the hopes of youth still painted in its features. Sometimes it's old, older than faith, older than wisdom, older than time. And sometimes it's a bit of both all at once. Sometimes it's gritty and pained, remembering the face of another who has fallen. Sometimes it's laughing, pleased to have a moment of peace. Most of the time it's proud, because it knows, oh yes, that face knows, the world is a different place, a better place because of it. Next time you look at a soldier's face, see if you can find that glint of pride. Sometimes it's hidden, and you have to search it out. You'll find it in the eyes, always, always in the eyes. For the eyes are indeed the windows to the soul, even a soldier's soul. And when you've carefully examined every feature of that soldier's face, stand up straight and tall and smile your best smile, thank that soldier, because it does what some cannot or will not. It defends what it believes to be right with its very life. But more important, it defends a perfect stranger, you and me. And when you see a flag-covered casket, stand in memoriam for all the soldiers Stand in memoriam of all the soldiers' faces you've examined. For when one of them falls, they all fall. And when one of them stands, they all stand. In Lillian's answer, I think I found the answer to the question I've been asked so many times. Why do we fight so far away for other people? Why do we sacrifice so many of our own for others? Because in the hearts and the very souls of our men and women that serve in our armed forces, that gave their ultimate sacrifice, they understood that if we don't defend the dream, the reality of freedom, we will lose that reality and it will only be a dream. It will be lost to tyranny and evil. The dream that is America is the dream of all mankind for all of time. The ability and freedom to make our own choices, to say what we want to say, or to worship how we want to worship, to defend ourselves if we choose, to tell our leaders how to lead. That is why we honor those that lay here and across our nation and around the world. Each of them understood that if we let evil win in places far from our shores, then the fight comes here and we are not protected. That is what they have died for. That is what they lived for. For us, to protect us and to protect the reality that is America, and provide the opportunity for millions of people around the globe to seek a better life and to live the reality of the American dream. Today, we honor those that have fallen and the sacrifices they and their families have made. It is a solemn occasion. However, it is also an occasion for celebration. It is an opportunity to celebrate each and every life, and I must admit, I have not lost a family member to a battle. I have lost a few friends over the years that have served in the military. And from my experiences with them, and from the stories my father told me, so you know that's got to be a long time ago, they would want us, they would understand, and they did understand, the gravity of today. They also would want us to celebrate their lives. So this is what I'm going to do, and I ask that you do something similar. After today's ceremonies, when you get back home, or wherever you're going, you go to that backyard, go out to your patio, you cook your hamburgers and your brats, and you have a good time with your friends. And with your beverage of choice, raise it high and toast those that we have lost. Toast their lives, toast their memory. On behalf of Civil Air Patrol and the Airmen of Michigan Wing, I say thank you. We do remember, we will always remember and honor you. May God bless their souls, and may God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you, Curtis. And now we will have the Laying of Wreaths, followed by Amazing Grace, performed by the Kalamazoo Pipe Band. Take it away, Floyd.
Didn't bring one, so they're going to be back with the Blue Stars, so go ahead. Bill, go ahead. Line up the flagpole. As soon as they start to walk away, line up the flagpole.
First wreath, Military Order of the Purple Heart, Chapter 110. Military Order of the Purple Heart, Auxiliary, Chapter 110. Blue Star Mother is chapter 186, accompanied along with a Gold Star Mother. Up to the flagpole.
They want you to introduce the Duke. So, his name is...
Department of Michigan, Veterans of Foreign Wars. And the Department of Michigan, Veterans of Foreign Wars Auxiliary.
Go.
Go.
That's a DAV.
Oh, it's a DAV? Okay. Out of sequence. DAV, Chapter 7. Up to the flagpole. Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 73, Holland, Michigan. Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 313, Battle Creek, Calhoun County. Yeah. Now I got to go back up to the VF jump.
Yeah. Out of sequence, are they?
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Vietnam Dog Handlers Association. Now we have the Department of Michigan, VFW, Veterans of Foreign Wars.
I don't.
Department of Michigan, Veterans of Foreign Wars Auxiliary. American Legion Post 298. American Legion Post 298 Auxiliary. American Legion, Sons of the American Legion, Squadron 298. American Legion Riders from Post 298. And Sam. Yeah. American Legion Post 36. American Legion Post 257. American Legion Post Auxiliary 257. Ambets, District 5.
Veterans Auxiliary Department of Mission.
Yep. The Department of Michigan, Polish Legion of American Veterans and Auxiliary. Horse Riders. The Patriot Guard Riders. Last and not but least, the Navy League of the United States.
ladies and gentlemen, the Kalamazoo Pipe Band. Before we close, we have a few folks and organizations we'd like to thank for helping us honor our fallen heroes today. Again, a big, huge thank you to Plumera Botanical Boutique for the beautiful roses. All, yes, please. All of the organizations that provided wreaths in honor of our military family members laid to rest here at Fort Custer. We have quite a few of them. Let's give them a big round of applause for honoring them today. And as always, our Patriot Guard riders, Legion riders, and horse riders, and they stand here with the flags, the flag line, honoring us today. Thank you very much. Let's give them a round of applause. And I hope they can hear us over there, because every year they come out and do it. The American Legion 298 Women's Auxiliary, providing us all the water, cookies, refreshments. Let's give them a big round of applause, certainly today, of all they do. Mr. Lance Pridemore and the outstanding staff here at Cemetery. Don't they do a great job for us? Look at this national treasure. Of course, my friends at the 110th Attack Wing and the Color Guard, they do us the honors every year. Thank you for coming again. Later, Lieutenant Colonel Nicholas Batch and Mr. John Edwards will do rendering of taps. The Kalamazoo Pipe Band, thank you again. Our Serial City Concert Band, led by Dr. Stephen White. Let's give them a round of applause. And of course, all of our Gold Star mothers, families, this is what it's all about today. God bless all of you. I hope this doesn't screw up the program just a bit here, but we're going to go into the medley band. We're going to do our presentations. After that, we have a couple pilots that's going to join us here. So we're going to give them just a second. This is one of those musical arrangements that we always do every year at Memorial and Veterans Day. It's our Armed Forces Medley, performed by the Serial City Concert Band. So we want you to stand or raise your hand when you hear the service song of the branch you're serving, served, or you're a family member of one who has served. So when the band gets ready over there, I threw a little ringer in on them. Thank you for accommodating us. Anytime you're ready. Ladies and gentlemen, United States Coast Guard. United States Marine Corps. United States Air Force. There's one more, right? Okay, the United States Navy. Gentlemen, your Serial City Concert Band under the direction of Dr. Stephen White. Okay, now I have the distinct honor of providing three special presentations. First, to our keynote speaker. Come on up here. Let me read the citation. With deep appreciation, the Fort Custer National Cemetery Advisory Committee expresses gratitude to Colonel Curtis J. Bomer, Commander of the Michigan Wing Civil Air Patrol, for delivering an inspiring keynote address, Memorial Day Ceremony, Program of Remembrance, 27 May 28. I often wonder if it wasn't inspiring, if we'd have to change that.
Probably.
Okay, but it was inspiring, wasn't it, ladies and gentlemen? Listen, give a big round of applause. Our next presentation goes to the Battle Creek Civil Air Patrol Cadet Squadron, who leads a program called Reefs Across America. And here at Fort Custer, Reefs Across America, it's a nationwide program which distributes holiday wreaths as a tribute to veterans laid to rest in national cemeteries. And I've been out here before, and it's not this hot when they do it. In fact, it's very cold. But they come out every year. So on behalf of Fort Custer, if I could have the representative, Debbie Stanstrom, come on up, representing the squadron. The Fort Custer National Cemetery Advisory Committee pays tribute to the Battle Creek Civilian Air Patrol Cadet Squadron for their commitment and support to our country's veterans through the Wreaths Across America project. In laying each wreath, these individuals remember not the veterans passing, but pay tribute to the lives they lived and their service to this country. This recognition is hereby presented 27 May 2018. Did our pilots make it, Barb? I guess you're going to have to come up, dear, if you wouldn't mind. This is sort of a question. We were going to try to get a couple of our pilots back from the hooligans, but unfortunately, probably They didn't get a chance to make it over in time. This is Barb Hibisky. She is the spouse of our lead pilot, Tom Hibisky. Also on the color guard. Also a member of the Stereo City Concert Band. I don't know where you have all the time to do all of this, Barb.
I don't sleep.
I know. But obviously, we are thrilled to death to have the hooligans. Don't they do a great time every year coming to the flyovers? And we'll make sure, I know Barb will make sure that Tom, Chuck, and all of them show our appreciation for us. So with deep appreciation, the Fort Custer National Cemetery Advisory Committee expresses heartfelt gratitude to the Hooligan Flight Team for their continued support in honoring the country's veterans through the inspirational, memorable, and moving flyovers at the Fort Custer National Cemetery Shrine in Augusta, Michigan. This recognition is hereby presented 27 May 2018, and by the way, they made me an honorary member, so I feel very honored to present this to you. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we will have the rendering of military honors. A rifle salute by the Fort Custer National Cemetery Friday Honor Guard. Echo taps will be rendered by Lieutenant Colonel Nicholas Batch, U.S. Army, retired, and Mr. John Edwards. Pastor Todd Terevest will give the benediction. Please be advised of the loud sounds by the gunfire.
May the Lord our God bless all who are present here to memorialize those who lived and died to preserve liberty and freedom in our nation and in our world. And may the Lord our God remember all those who sacrificed, gave us nation, this nation its greatness and progress. May our memory for all of those who served in the armed forces be an honorable one, full of thanksgiving to the Lord, and may we remember with much love and mercy those who died in the service of our country. Let us depart in peace and in love and in charity with our neighbors. May we be joined together in the common goal of service to our God and our country. Amen.
Please stand if you're able for the retiring of the colors by the 110th Attack Wing, the Legion Riders Group, and the Kalamazoo Pipe Band. Retire the colors.
Hey. Oh, where? Heart.
couple of announcements before we conclude the program. There's election at Augusta VFW 7956 in Augusta immediately following. And also refreshments will be served at the American Legion Post 298 on 20th Street, Battle Creek. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for attending and taking time on this beautiful Sunday afternoon to remember. God bless our military, veterans, their families, and God bless the United States of America.
Your voice, your community.